Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for your patience. We're a few minutes late, but thank you for joining us. I am Jen Miller. I'm the marketing specialist here at Micro Solutions and also your host. And I am accompanied today with two beautiful, lovely people who know a lot more about things than I do. We have Brett Lechtenberg, who, as we were just discussing, has four businesses under his belt. He can tell you more about that later. And then Rod Busby, who is out in California at Explosive Fit, both fitness and martial arts. He has a lot of stuff in his noggin. Again, we're going to talk about that. And so today we are discussing money and your members and how to build a stronger community while also balancing finance. The two of them seem like they're at odds, but they can coexist, I promise you. So, Brett, since I gave you a quick introduction, want to tell our audience a little bit more about what you do and how wonderful and impressive you are.
Okay, no pressure there. Yeah, I've had my martial arts school here in Utah. It'll be 23 years, August 4th. Been a Member Solutions client since before they were Member Solutions, probably 22 years. I don't know exactly. Back in the APS days, and even before that, when it was Fitness Funding, I think was the name. Yeah, I'm a big proponent in using a billing company. It was when we first started getting clients and started getting busy, it was one of the very first things we looked for to take a lot of pressure off of my wife and I, because we were just running our business ourselves at that point and managing, accounts and delinquencies and follow-up calls and all and membership, all that. You definitely need some help. And so Member Solutions was the solution for us. After interviewing several companies, and again, they were had just had a different name, but we've been with them, never left, never gonna, especially with wonderful people like Jennifer here and Rob. So
I like you
so yeah, I'm a big proponent of billing and having a support team, and Member Solutions is our chosen support team because I think they're the best in the industry. So.
Thank you. Could not be. My heart is glowing, honestly. That was amazing.
All right, I'm out. I made the heart glow. I'm out. You guys got to carry the show.
And Rod, please give our audience a little bit more about what you do and like any other details you want to add.
Yeah. Hey, guys. My name's Rod. I'm out here in California. You can tell tank top, and I know probably a couple layers on, or is it heating up out there?
No, it's hot here right now, but I just came from a meeting that wasn't tank top appropriate.
Yeah, and we got a camp going on, so I'm just out there doing thing. And thank you, Jennifer, for having me on. My wife is the owner of Explosive Fit. I'm the worker bee. You can tell by the 5 a.m. daddy bags I have, waking up and training clients here. We facilitate fitness, and my background would be martial arts. We also cater to kids in martial arts, so it works very synergistic with what we have. We've been a part of Member Solutions really from the day we really started. Once I felt square, part of me using it wasn't going to be a system. I did look out to our account manager currently at Member Solutions, and from there we just never looked back. The ease of mind of just not having to deal with that, but also the support that I've received from them, tremendous. So I'm more than happy to speak without not only our experience, but why billing does matter. It's super uber important if they're not taking advantage of
My heart is so full right now. It's
that.
a little overwhelming, but y'all are pretty fantastic. So, to go off that a little bit more, and this is going to be super casual, like we've talked about. I really want to start with your personal journeys with building stronger communities in your respective businesses. How you've dealt with finances in the past versus how you deal with them now, and particularly any recommendations you can give to other people in the industry, because finances can be a really scary topic. And as entrepreneurs, when you are making your own money, there's a lot more pressure than just waiting for a paycheck every 2 weeks from another employer. Mm-hmm. So Brett or Rod, feel free to speak your experiences, either.
Yeah, I'll just pick up the ball from there. I think as you get into running your school, there's no guidebook, and there's a lot of gurus and a lot of misinformation out there. And they can, I remember back in the day, I'm not sure, Brett, the big thing about, you know, cashing out clients, and that's the smart way to do it, and that's the way you should do it. And then there's this other side says, no, reoccurring billing, it's smart because it's predictable and this and that. And you just don't know where to go. I know for me, the greatest thing about the way we have billing set up is that we're able to facilitate full, is be able to do a percentage of our program is paid in full and a percentage is reoccurring. So it's predictable income. As a business owner, and I have staff and I have team here, I want to make sure that number one, they're taken care of, but then also we have our percentages in line of what we are spending. So once again, having a billing company not only is upfront, ethical, and predictable. So yes, they are getting paid, but at the same time, they're not taking such a big percentage where it just doesn't make sense. And and being in California, I'm wearing the tank top because of the luxury tax we have out here, that 13%, you know, sun and snow tax that we have. And, you know, it can be really hard sometimes to get a leg up. So when I say support is, I remember just being able to be talked through about not only the transition into a billing service, because it is scary. You're starting to talk about money and finances and now taking care of people's cards and their private information. It can get very fuzzy with people, and being an ease of being able to give them a card and say, hey, at any time, if you need anything, you need to change anything, these are the person that we can help. But also on the other end, and sorry, Brett, jump in at any time, is, you know, being able to be a professional. You know, my profession is getting to people in shape. And just like Brett, we're hoping to impact some kids in the community. My expertise is not ACH. My expertise is not EFT. You know, I don't want to be the bank for someone. I don't want to do that. I would rather everybody come to an adult decision and say, hey, if you're going to be a part of our program, fantastic. Here's how we facilitate the membership. And that's through an automatic draft or however that is. So absolutely. Billing is uber important. Billing has to be established in your program if you're going to be successful, especially in this membership style business.
Yeah. And you basically covered it all. I'm a believer in having teams, right? So your financial team. So you talked about Jennifer, things being scary. Well, they become less scary the more you learn about them, right? So having an accountant that you can trust, right? That's part of your financial team. Having somebody who's monitoring your accounts receivable, like Member Solutions, is part of your financial team.
Mm-hmm.
Someone who's responsible in your business to make sure that your expenditures inside the business are running accordingly, and your marketing and other things. Those things all have to be coordinated. And it can seem like a lot, but again, the more you learn about it, the less it becomes scary. So for us, when we were looking, you know, one of the first things we decided was, we need a team. So we got as we got going, we interviewed several accountants, got an accountant. We went through and interviewed several billing companies, picked, you know, Member Solutions. Just like, you know, when we started a family, we interviewed doctors, dentists. We just did our due diligence.
Mm-hmm.
I think if you don't avoid things and you actually just approach them head on and you know what you're looking for, you've got an idea of what matters most to you, then great. And like Rod was saying, you know, are you going to cash people out or are you going to put everybody on billing? That's totally about what you're comfortable with. My recommendation is always to people, there's going to be people who want to pay in cash, but if you're cashing out more than, say, 20% of your population, your prices are probably too low, right? And so you can raise your price and you can add those people to billing. So we do like an 80-20 and we use that as a barometer to tell us whether or not we need to raise prices. If we start cashing out too many people, we know that our price is undervalued and our price is too low in the market. That's the way I look at it. And I'm always looking for systems or ways to make it easy for my staff to look at, for me to look at and manage. Go ahead, Ron.
No, I think you talked about that. I wrote down that note right there. It's a team. I never really thought about that, but you hit that on the head. That billing service, your accountant, your bookkeeper, they're really your staff, and they're all helping facilitate your location, your facility. I know you have four businesses, Brett. So that Superman, I love that. So I'm sure that it makes the, you know, the bigger your team, the bigger the dream, and vice versa. Yeah, you're right. You have to have that. And that 80-20 rule, that's something that we strive for too. And that's our personal preference because, right, we love to have that, but we don't want to get away from that. And that puts us in trouble. So I second with that.
Yeah, and I'd say too, one thing I didn't mention, but I'm willing to bet Rod has, is a payroll company. You got staff, use a payroll company so that your taxes are taken care of, at least for your employees, you know, and so that you don't end up in trouble, and you can, makes it easier to get some of your insurances and other things too. When they look at your payroll, you figure out how much you're going to pay in workman's comp and those. I don't know what it's like in California, but here, you know, they're always looking at your payroll wage and determining how much those things are going to cost. And you don't want to get, the last thing you want to do is get caught by the government not paying for workman's comp and stuff, because they can close you down and they can charge you some huge money. So
yeah, this is slowly turning into the little things you should know before starting. Honestly, these are the surprising, shocking things you quickly find out when you're like, wow, you know, we've signed up X amount of members, and then at the end of the year you're getting these bills, and having that team that can guide you and give you a heads up on what's going on is very important. That's why cash flow is important. You've got to have that cash flow available to be able to dip into, because if you're running every day in your whole month to month, paycheck to paycheck, where everything comes out even, you're going to be quickly surprised and hit. So building your bill of billing up to that 80 percentile, maybe more, maybe less, depending on what you're doing. And Brett says some great guidelines that 20%, your prices are too low. And I'm a big believer of getting paid for what you're worth, no matter what that rate is. You should, because there'll be someone out there who does it. But being able to have that cushion every month where you know, okay, hey, just in case Uncle Sam decides to hit us with a little you have that covered, and you're and you can continue running your business, because, you know, we get into this career because we do want to help people generally. And that's what we're trying to do. And it's not easy, and it's a day-to-day grind, and you're always out there. And yes, we always have to, you know, recruit and revenue and retention. We have to do all that day-to-day. But also in the back of our heads, we do have to make sure our margins are still there. And billing does facilitate having, you know, cash flow that comes in if you need it.
Yep, absolutely.
So then, aside from the more operational aspects that we've been discussing, what about more focused on your members and having those financial discussions? I would say, how are you having these kinds of discussions before you had some sort of billing system implemented in your process? And then what were those conversations like after? And have you seen any difference between the two?
Well, I'll jump in on this one first. It's been so long for me to not have a billing company. I have just kind of faint memories.
But we never in that, Brett, because I was like 23 years ago. I want to know.
I think when you're in this business, just like Rod said, you want to help people. And when you want to help people, the last thing you want to do is always talk to them about money. Hey, can I get your tuition check, or can I get your membership dues or whatever? That's not the relationship you want with people. At least we didn't, and I'm sure Rod didn't either by the sounds of it. And so just being able to take that off your plate and let clients know, look, this is a totally safe and secure way. We don't have to talk about money unless there's some kind of problem. If there's a problem on our end, you know, I remember back in the day, we just EFTs were not a big thing back then, right? They were you obviously could be done, but they weren't as common. And for us, it was like, look, if there's ever a problem, we guarantee to refund your money within 24 hours upon proof that, you know, it was our fault. And so people took us at our word, and, you know, over 20 some years, we've probably had two or three problems. I mean, you're going to have something, but it's basically nothing, right? And so, and none of them were a big deal. So that's what I recall, is just that we just didn't want to have that relationship. We were there to train them or their child in martial arts and leadership and, you know, pass the initial membership, you know, in an occasional event or a piece of equipment or whatever. You know, that was just the way we wanted to focus on it. And so that's what we did. And that's why we wanted a billing company.
Yeah, when we started, you know, it was right in the age of card readers. Mm-hmm. So you know, for me as a gym, I just wanted to get started. So there wasn't forethought into billing. It was just, okay, card reader there. Brett said something. We're, you know, helping people. You're not going to help people if you're going out and asking, hey, do you have your card? And then all of a sudden you become the whole negotiator. Let me go ahead and discount it a month. You can't afford it. How about this and that? That doesn't become your job helping people. Your job helping people is actually dedicating more time on the mat or on the floor. That's where your best bet. Also, helping people, we do a big part of our program is our community-based efforts. So I know for myself as a community, and we match whatever is donated. No, you know, I have to have, make sure I have to have funds in there to do that. And when I match a donation, that is really, truly me helping people, right? Mm-hmm. And so it's not me sitting there and chasing down money. It's actually my time dedicating more out in the community, more with my members, getting out there, creating awareness. That is where my time is best served, not chasing down people for their credit cards or having the look, we are more than happy to discount, but I do like the fact that when they know that you are a proper set of business, they understand that you're a little bit more serious, and what you're getting into is your money's worth is going to be, you're going to get your money's worth, pardon me, for what you're paying for. So having a billing company really allows me to be a professional business, command a professional wage. And with that being said, building up my billing enough where I'm comfortable to give back to community and help even more people versus the guy with the card reader 5 years ago saying, hey, having that uncomfortable conversation.
I go back to four card readers, just saying, we still did the.
Yeah, I was going to ask. You should have it up on the wall, Brad. I want to see that. If I turn the camera to the left.
I wish I did have that at this point. There's some things I wish I had, like the first T-shirt we ever made, the card reader. Yeah, there's some things that, that was a mistake to not keep those things.
Stuff you should know about before starting. That should have been the topic. We're going down memory lane here.
Absolutely. We actually just got a comment in that I want to read out loud and make sure that everyone hears this because I think it's a really good point. Sarah in our chat box says that members tend to avoid showing up if they know they owe money, mm-hmm. and business owners are going to ask about it when they walk in the door. No show leads to attrition. Being able to work with third party for arrangements gives the member peace of mind to show up and not feel embarrassed.
Yeah, very true. Very true. I mean,
I think that's a really good point. I myself, like, I'm a fitness junkie. I've been in various amounts of both known and obscure sports, like anything from rock climbing, dragon boating, you name it, I've probably done it. But one of the core things that I do is a yoga practice. And I know by showing up and feeling secure, Brett, like you said, that if anything comes up, I'm going to feel more comfortable talking to the teachers or talking to the owners who I know. It's not going to ruin the relationship because they've helped me feel like this is a safe community that I can be a part of.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I would agree with that 100%. And we always take a proactive approach. You know, we look at our, you know, we get a delinquency report every day, and we look at it, and it's usually not much on it. But when there is, you know, depending on what it is, if we see the person, we say, hey, we just want to make sure everything's okay. It gives us a service touch point. Just saw something happen. Want to make sure that there was not an issue or problem that we could help with.
Right.
The vast majority of the time, it's just somebody's credit card expired.
Yeah.
Right. And it just, they didn't update it, or it was something really small. And we always approach it from the point of we're just reaching out to make sure if there's anything we can help with, can we facilitate? And people way more often than not, you know, 90% of the time, just really appreciate the fact that we noticed, we're in tune. It's not just some robot collecting money, but we also see and we're also involved.
Right, right. And interestingly enough, out-of-date credit cards, cards that are declined, that's one of the biggest reasons that members don't come back, even though they may be happy, again, with the embarrassment of like, oh no, what if I owe them money, and all of that emotion around it. Mm-hmm. So I would venture to say that, like you said, Brett, it's a way to have this conversation that still feels inclusive, mm-hmm. and not confrontational.
Yep, absolutely.
Yeah, you know, when a member comes in and a mom is, you know, three kids and has 100 things to do, maybe calling and updating her card is the last thing that she wants to do. You know, we send out courtesy texts just, you know, as a courtesy and just say, hey, is everything okay? We got to notice that your card might be off. Next time you're in, if you want to bring in a check or update. So we've been slowly transitioning over to ACH to kind of help people out so that they don't have that inconvenience of their cards are stolen or expired and they have to get, which is very common nowadays. And I think we have to be considerate of that, is of the fact that, hey, it's not always their fault and they're not a bad person. And, you know, no burpees before you jump on the mat because you're late.
Or late. Is that wrong? No knuckle push-ups?
but, you know, just being considerate of the time and day that we're in. And it's a common thing. I know it happens to me. And, you know, I don't want to be berated because of an accident or an incident that I'm not. I'm 100% in support of your gym. I want to be here. I want to go here. I'm 100% ready to get it going. But also having someone that is following up and I can refer them to makes it better.
Mm-hmm. Rod, I want to go back to something that you mentioned. You were talking about that there are so many little things that when you were thinking about, I just want to open a gym and help people. Did you in particular have any misconceptions about what a billing service actually entailed when you were starting out? Did you have any thoughts of like, this is something maybe I can do myself, or maybe like anything that you've seen online? Because from what I've seen from my research, a lot of business owners have some not so true ideas of what billing actually is, and more to your experience about lining up those details to actually open a business and be successful as you are. Do you have any thoughts around that?
Yeah, you know, for me, it's a little bit of a different story, Jennifer, just only because I did have experience with Member Solutions prior to Explosive Fit. So I was well known and a big fan of this company. So I already knew when I got to a certain point, I was switching to a billing service. Mm-hmm. Take it from some of and my background too, Brett, is martial arts. So that's where, you know, we did find Member Solutions with through the martial arts. But it's where I see now, because we started off as a fitness gym here, out of my garage. It's really hard, Brett, to get women with kids to your garage, to your house,
and be. It's a little stalkerish.
I know it can be done, but it is very hard to do. Who would have known?
Yeah.
So we started the fitness route, and once I got to, you know, people to know, like, and trust me, then we started doing martial arts, and we opened up our first location, and we expanded from there. But I do work with personal trainers, and it's amazing of the trainers that consult with myself to get advice, how they are not doing billing, how their systems are very archaic, pad notes written down, and they're still doing, you know, 10 pack sessions and trying to chase at the end and having, how awkward is that conversation to have month after month after month? Month one, hey, Jim, just so you know, your session's up. By month 10, you're using an excuse like, hey, the sky's blue, 10 sessions, please. You know, like whatever opener you can find to get that conversation going, it's very uncomfortable because when you build that relationship with a client, they slowly become not just a client, but a part of your fitness family, your martial arts family. Mm-hmm. Which family member wants to talk about money all the time? That's what makes people not want to talk to each other. So I know for myself, I try to coach and preach to these starting trainers. You know, it seems like in the martial arts world, billing seems very like everyone's really book smart to that. You know, that's what you need to do, get everyone on billing. But in the fitness realm, it just doesn't seem to be right one of those necessities. So that's usually the challenge. I see that with a lot of the younger trainers in there. And I know right away, set up billing. Here's a great company I know, but, you know, do your research and figure out what's best for you.
Yeah. I'd agree with that 100%. Ditto.
Yeah. I mean, it's very, you know, I think it's a lack of knowledge, you know, because in the martial arts world, it's a little bit different because you're in a school and you're a system and you might get to a certain belt and you might start jumping in there and starting to help out and teach and coach. So you get a little bit of work experience in there. Mm-hmm. In fitness, it's the opposite. You go get certified and they throw you in and you're by yourself. So you're learning as you go. So not any wrong viewing. It's just we just kind of do with what we have. So there's no proper education there on how to really properly run your small business, big business, whatever you turn it into.
Right.
So a question for the both of you, and we can also bounce off a Rod on this one. Do you have any recommendations regarding helpful policies within your respective businesses, whether it's about money or any sort of structure that you found particularly enhances your member relationships, makes things easier, better?
I guess the number one thing is nobody pays us directly. We just don't allow that. They pay their down payment or maybe their first month's payment. But after that, it's just policy. We do not take direct payments unless you're going to pay your membership off in full, which again, small percentage. And everybody goes on EFT. We don't put anybody on statement billing unless there's an extremely odd situation. Mm-hmm. And occasionally, you know, a couple times a year, you might get that. But that's probably our biggest policy. And number two on that is if you ever have an issue, you've got the billing company to turn to and you've got us. We work together. We're here for your benefit. We're here for you to become successful with our program. We'll do whatever we can. So please don't hesitate to talk to one or both of us. Yeah. Just truly try and be totally transparent. And when in doubt, though, billing company first, us second, when it comes to like if they need to make payment arrangements or something.
Right. So we're right there with you. So I'm doing it right, Brett. I'm doing it right. Our policy is we do not handle payments. And my shock, we actually don't even handle cash in our facility. Mm-hmm. And the other thing I add is I only have one person in charge of that. So everything has to flow through her. So if there is someone wants to purchase something, sign up, it's all done through the one person. Now, obviously I can sub in and do that too. But what that allows us is to make sure that there's no hearsay, he says, she say, right? Mm-hmm. Oh, I paid her and they gave it to him. It's there. The reason we do no cash there is not a trust, is actually through Member Solutions. I'm not sure if you guys know, but the web note system, instead of me taking cash and you know, having to do a receipt, I write a web note to Member Solutions and they bill at the end of the month. And the best part is it just adds on to their membership billing. So it allows us to have a same system as swiping their card, because there is a psychological, I think, kind of value of not having to always ask someone to pull out their credit card.
Mm.
And it's not that we're trying to monopolize everybody here. No, it's not. It's just convenience. Mm-hmm. Convenience of someone saying, can you charge that to my card? Yes, we can. So we have that policy in there. And you're right. If someone has an issue, 100%, the first person you turn to is the billing company. A lot of times they don't get that answer they like. So then once again, that person is directed back to my admin, my office manager here, Aline, and she goes ahead and makes a judgment call based off our policies that works best for us.
Yeah.
And the member.
I just had some more comments come in that I think I would love to share out loud. Sarah again says, martial arts tends to have a longer standing relationship with members, where fitness seems to be more like people leave, just get more people in. I would, speaking for Sarah, I would love to see the retention mindset shift in fitness.
Yeah.
I think, you know, in the fitness industry, I think you're going to keep people longer, obviously, as long as they're seeing results. In martial arts, it's kind of got belts and there's recognition and there's other things. So people see that result. In fitness, if people see their weight going down or their muscle going up or whatever they're after, they're going to stay longer too. So it's just a different kind of belt rank system, I guess.
I agree with that. There are some systems out there that do run your gym like a belt system. There's a couple programs out there, and I think they do a phenomenal job. I'll be honest, I run my fitness program like a martial arts program, and not in the sense I have belts, but what do kids really look for? They love to have fun. They love to have achievements and goals. So we run challenges as a program. We run member challenges where only my member come in. And we go back to what I said. How am I going to help people? Well, number one, if I get a billing company and I get all my percentages in my company in line where I have a little bit of something after, I'm going to – sorry, my summer camp guys are leaving. I'm waving. I'm actually reinvesting into my members. So currently at the end of right after the 4th of July, we're giving away a 3-month membership to one of my clients, not a new member off the street. Just all we're doing is a burpee challenge every day. They have to do one more burpee than yesterday, and they videotape it and they're tagged. That is the way, same thing we would do in martial arts, earning stripes and earning belts. We run our fitness program like a martial arts program. We do special events, social nights. We make sure that every class ends with some type of fun five. Or, you know, it might not be the fun five you love where it's like push-ups, but it gets them smiling and sweating because I have like the thong song on and they're working their glutes and they think it's funny, haha. But it creates memory and emotion. And that's what we do in martial arts for our kids. We make it fun. As they get in better shape, we got to get a little bit more serious, right? It doesn't have to be as fun. And you have that segment of your crowd, just like your red belts, your black belts. You have that segment. But fitness can be ran just like martial arts and can be a great, great program. And you can have the same retention as in martial arts if you take the time to spice it up a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I would – I've got the – fitness kickboxing side. I've got the fitness kickboxing business. I've got the martial arts business, and we're just now implementing all around fitness classes. Right. I've got a friend who's a 3-time Olympian and has trained NFL players, et cetera, et cetera. And we're partnering up to specifically bring people a cutting edge fitness program with martial arts, with our kickboxing, to create something even more robust. Because I don't know about in Rod's area, but we have so many people who will jump onto things like ClassPass and a couple of services where they can go to multiple gyms all the time, and because they're kind of brainwashed into believing that you have to have 6 different gym memberships and you've got to try these 12 different diets over time, and you've got, there's just, it's just full of misinformation. And so we're working hard really just educate our community on the realities of fitness, the realities of nutrition, and what we do and what we call fill the gaps, and have a broad spectrum of super fun, high energy programs with great people, but get great results. So I'm looking forward to us chatting more, Rod, even after this call. So I'd love
I was looking at your bully system and wanted to get some questions on that, and I'm more than happy to help you out. But on the fitness side, since we're going down that route, you know, a big shift I had was, and I don't want to contradict what Brett said, because I think employing high energy, you said it there, high energy, good people into your program is an absolute must, whether it's martial arts or fitness. Mm-hmm. You know, cannot motivate boring.
Yeah.
Try it at 5 a.m. Right. You cannot motivate boring. You have to be a level 10. And that's something I would coach. But one big shift that I've done with my gym is I've told my members, look, I don't want to be your everything. I don't want to be your everything. I want to be a part of your fitness journey, but I'm going to be your biggest cheerleader when you go out and try a Zumba class, because I'm the facilitator of that. And what's great about it is when you get comfortable with that and you get comfortable with your members trying out other things, what they slowly realize is that, wow, they have a really good thing back here. It really reinforces there. I think some people feel so self-conscious of their members going somewhere else. And I know in martial arts, that's a big ordeal, right? Training at other gyms, right? What we have to do is we have to relax and be confident in what we can offer to that person that no one else can. And we have to also understand that spinning can offer something that I cannot, but together we can impact that mom's life, dad's life, or that child's life in helping them do what we want to be. And that's being a pillar of our community, or being the healthy mom, or being the lighthouse. Dad is a lighthouse. When he goes and work, he motivates 10 other people to start their fitness journey. And that's really what we do. And we get people out there motivated, looking good, feeling good about themselves. And that way they make other people feel good. Right?
Yeah. And I like your comment about the lighthouse. I'm not sure if everybody gets that analogy, but I definitely know where you're coming from there.
Thank you.
Yeah, be the lighthouse wherever you are, right? And so I'm with you 100%. With you 100%.
Yeah. And, you know, a lot of it is, you know, as owners or as coaches or as instructors on the mat is learning how to be a leader and learning how to motivate and also coming up with new things. And let's go take this back. If I'm there and I have 50 members, 25, 100, 200 members, and I'm personally calling everyone to get an updated credit card information, I'm not working on me. I'm not working on myself being a better coach. I'm not working on servicing my members the best you can, because they depend on me Monday morning, wakey, wakey, morning, sunshine, you know, and getting them fired up for a week of monotonous 9-to-5 traffic, you know, kids, tire has a flat tire. I need to motivate these people. Brett needs to get his kids ready for whatever challenges are going to come when they go to school, whether it's someone looking them in the eye and asking them their name, or it's a big soccer game and they're scared, but hey, remember, if I can break two boards, I can score a goal. Doesn't matter what it is, right? Doesn't matter what it is. It's our job to be ready and prepared, because people are counting on us. That's why they have signed on the dotted line saying, hey, I promise you to pay X as long as you deliver what you've been promising me all along.
Right.
Man, yeah. I'm getting fired up, Jen. Let's do this.
I'm so glad.
It's time to start a workout video. Let's go.
Let's do it, bro.
So one of the things I really want to drive home here, and this isn't just based off of, you know, my being a part of Member Solutions. This is just something that I hear a lot from all the clients that I talk to. Part of what I really like about speaking with clients is we're able to get really personal, because opening a business in both martial arts and fitness is really personal. You are taking a part of yourself and you're putting it out in the community. So time management is a huge thing, and we've talked about that a little bit. And it's the same sentiment that I've heard from other clients I've spoken to on the phone. And with the time that you have by not spending all of, you know, all of your time doing the admin, the paperwork, the money, do you have any recommendations for our attendees and other viewers how to build a really strong community with the time you're saving by not doing your own billing?
If I'm understanding your question, it's kind of two parts. So one part, if you look at it as time management, I think you'll always struggle. Look at it as habit management and creating, looking to create the, to use every bit of your time towards either member engagement or member enrollment. Either way, it becomes very synergistic. And everything else, find a way to delegate it out or just totally get rid of it. Because there's a lot of things that people get focused on that they think are crucial. But if you really looked at it from 30,000 feet, you'd be like, why? You look back 5 years later after being in business, you start thinking, why was I so focused on that in month six? I just, you know, for 2 years I focused on that and it doesn't make any sense, right? So it's trying to step back, give yourself a little bit of space. Think about habit management on those two areas is going to pay you big dividends, I think. And then that just naturally allows you to be able to create better experiences for your people and create the culture that you want. I'm big on culture. Really big on internal culture, whether it's internal culture of one of my facilities or it's internal culture when I go to a school. It's what do you bring in, how you bring in the value, right? In the lighthouse, are you bringing the heat, right? And you just have to be clear on what you're trying to do. For me, when I get in there, I think it's important to be focused on communication and having fun. Because if you can do those things, then everything else becomes comparatively easy.
Brett, I love the whole habit, man. I'm taking down notes, man. You're a ninja. I love it. Habit management is a perfect way to say that. You've got to make a habit. We're teaching our kids habits. We're teaching our members habits. We got to be a product of what we're out there doing. What I love to do is I love not only to delegate to my team, but also invest in them and investing my time. So whether that means not only do we have a weekly staff meeting, but we're also doing daily meetings, 30-minute meetings, not every day with the same person, but one day with another person, one day, and just addressing them. Not every time it's going to be something work-related. Sometimes it can be personal, health, life, what's going on, hey, you told me about that college class you were taking, and finding out what's important to them and making them happy and getting them, but also flowing the knowledge down, because I could be yelling out these things like lighthouse and, you know, all these other sayings, but if it only stays with me, they're not getting it. They're not understanding that message, and they're not able to impact my members. So when I can create them to be as impactful as me, then I can go back to a little bit more member engagement, like Brett said. And that means posting, reaching out, saying hi, asking people, are they happy here? How are things? Are you guys enjoying the program? How can I help you get to your goals faster? That to me is more important than really just putting up a Facebook ad. Because, you know, that is great and that's important. We got to get people out there, but we also got to get people to stay and make sure that we're delivering the product that they want. You mentioned culture, huge culture. Martin Rooney, I'm not sure if you've heard of him, Brett, but he has this talk on culture. It is phenomenal. I heard it earlier this year here in the LA Convention Center, but it's about culture, and he hit it on the head. Culture starts with you, right? Because if you don't run the culture runs itself. If you allow members at your gym to create that culture in there where people aren't paying or people are doing whatever they want, they're asking for discounts, then that is the culture of your gym.
Right.
Culture starts with you and what you set forth. And Martin Rooney has a great talk on that. He does some teaching coaching, more in the fitness world. But I wanted to throw that out there, Brett. Just I hope you and your team get to dive into that stuff, because I know we did. He has a book of the Culture Code, and it's phenomenal. It's great.
Thank you. The name's familiar. So I'll take a look at that. And I think, you know, kind of springboard off of Rod, he alluded to it, staff training is going to be something that frees up a substantial amount of your time.
Mm-hmm.
People say, oh, I don't have time to train my staff. Well, you better make time. Otherwise, your time is not going to be yours anymore. And I agree 100% with what Rod was saying. You got to have a little bit of time with your staff each day. We have them come in specifically 15 minutes earlier than they need to, just so we can talk to them.
Yep.
Let them know what they've got to do for the day, but also to find out what's their mindset for the day, right? We just had people graduating high school, getting out of college for the summer. I have a very young staff. I run everything I do with, well, youngest staff members, 14 to about 25. And I love it that way. I am all about millennials and younger, because we've been telling them their whole lives, if you can change the world, right? And most people struggle with that because they say millennials don't do this, they don't do that, and they're flaky in this. I say, look, you told them to change the world, but then you didn't show them how. Just show them how and watch them run.
That's right. You're absolutely right, Brett. Keep going, preach.
That's one of my things. I put it in my time management book that, you know, let the millennials, you told them to change the world, show them how. Step up and show them what you told them to do. You can't just expect that people will figure it out, because the first thing that happens, a confused mind says no. And as soon as it says no, it starts to just drift, right? Give them direction. Give them direction. So anyway.
something that I'm hearing from the both of you, just from our discussion, is that having good policies, having good systems, having a good billing partner really allows you to establish good value and good culture, and allows you to focus on a lot of the things that actually deserve your time. And I recently read an article, I think it was on a major news site, about a CEO who happens to be younger. And she was talking about how she didn't see herself as at the peak of the corporate ladder, but rather she's where she's the most useful, right? It's not about status. It's about, this is where I can contribute the most right now in this stage. And so I'm hearing that sentiment from the both of you, mm-hmm. is that by delegation and outsourcing some tasks, you're able to really do what you're great at and what you're supposed to be doing, where you can contribute the most.
Absolutely.
Yeah, in my case, I'm a little bit different. I know, you know, there's a lot of owners who love to step back and, you know, and create systems where they have coaches coach and teachers teach, and they're able to look at their company. I have a unique situation because I hate everything else besides getting in the fight with my clients. I love coaching. I love teaching. That's where I love to be. So you're right. I do have to delegate, but I have to create the right team to back me. So when I'm on the floor teaching and coaching, I have the sales system. I have the billing system. I have my retention system covered. So it allows me to have not only more time on the floor impacting my clients, but also allows me the flexibility to have some staff to take over so I can visit a school, do a nutrition talk and whatnot. So you're right. Yeah. Time management, habit management is super important. Having that time with your team and educating and growing them, delegating in all these systems. They're all systems.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all about systems. The way you do everything, you need to have a logbook. When you walk into your gym, the way you turn on the lights, the way you turn on the stereo, the way you open up the door even, you have to write it down, create a manual, and then everybody follows it. That right there. And then, Brett, what you talked about, making time for your staff, whether they're young or old, you know, not shoveling it aside. I have an older staff, actually. My staff is older. And at first, I didn't dedicate that time to them. I actually thought, oh, man, I don't have any time. They'll kind of learn as they go. And they actually really appreciate you taking the time to actually get that knowledge flow down to them. They really do appreciate it because you're investing in them, and they love it. They love having new skills.
Yeah.
And I would venture to say that trickles down to your members, and that contributes to the culture of the community and that feeling of I'm secure here and this is where I belong, and that contributes to retention and all that good stuff.
Yeah, I think turnover, sorry Brent, not to cut you off, but turnover is such a hard thing for your members. You, especially with kids, they get attached to your coaches, your instructors. And when you can really invest in your team, and what I don't mean, you don't always have to pay or give them a higher wage. That does go into it. But when you invest your time, your efforts and energy in them, and you give them a road path of growth, of not only are you going to grow here, but financially, mentally, physically, you can grow here. When you have all those paths taken care of from them, you'll keep your staff longer, which is peace of mind, because what you don't want, and I know Brett's situation, he's got four companies. If all of his employees were to leave right now and he has to juggle all those hats, it's going to be hard for him. So he has to make sure that he invests the time to them, not only in his time, but also in their happiness and quotient. And that means, are they happy and are we fulfilling something that they're continually wanting, you know, whether it's advancement or more pay or more time off, and having those conversations with your staff. I know we do them. You guys should too, because you'll find out something that you never knew about them.
Yeah. And I would say this, the number one determinant above all things of how your clients are going to be treated is the way that you treat your staff. Treat your staff poorly, your clients are going to be treated poorly. Even good people eventually get beat down, right? So treat them good, expect excellence for them, but understanding that, you know, there's an old saying that says people rise to their level of expectation. That's not true if they're not trained. They rise to their level of expectation, but they fall to their level of training. If you want people to excel, you want to have great culture, you got to have a great training structure. Every Monday, staff training. Every day, Monday through Thursday, there's 15-minute booster trainings for us. That worked well for us. I haven't hired a new person in over a year. I've only hired maybe even one person in the last couple of years, because just we keep everybody. And the one person I'm losing is because she's going off to college. And I'm replacing her with another younger person that I'll have, as long as we treat her well, I think, for a couple of years before she might go off to college or something. But they're also all product of the product.
Right.
We haven't hired from outside in, I can't remember what, right? We are constantly on the lookout for the next employee.
Great.
So we'll be wrapping up in a few minutes, but I want to say to our viewers, if you have any questions, please type them in the chat box. It is a little slow coming in, so I'm going to keep my eye on it. We do have a few more minutes. I would love some questions.
Make it quick, people, because I'm on the red bar on my laptop, and once it goes, I'm out. So
I see.
We can give you guys. Let us know.
Let's beat the red bar, people. Let's go. Beat the red bar.
It's countdown. All of a sudden, we're like a phone telephone. Come on, get your questions in.
All right now.
Rod, where are you at in California?
We're near LA, so Calabasas, San Fernando Valley area. That's where we reside, kind of really in the heart of the fitness, you know, realm. Actually, Far Bars is local in our area. Far Bars with TKC, Team Karate Center. Mm-hmm. He's really, very well known here. So we're surrounded. Dave Kovar is, you know, 4 or 5 hours away from us. So we're surrounded with some awesome, great talent out here, which is great, because it really makes us have to elevate the level of service. And that's really a quest that I want to see in not only the fitness, but also martial arts, is where we challenge each other to raise the level of service that we're providing, not just punches and kicks, but character education, proper member, you know, management and services, and also amenities, you know, some great clean gyms, and man, just over deliver every time.
Absolutely.
I did just get a question in, and this is open to both of you. Are there any unexpected benefits of billing that you've experienced? that you didn't anticipate.
Yeah, I talked about the WebNote feature. Mm-hmm. That was a big lifesaver because I really did want to have a system of just one flow in. So when it comes to registration for a workshop, when it comes to, hey, I would like a protein bar, as simple as that, or even a member membership, having the WebNote system through Member Solution, to me, was I didn't have to reinvest in a CRM system and whatnot. I already took what I had, which was a billing service, and without having to relearn a brand new system, I was able to add to it. And that was the really cool thing with our account manager. They were able to show that to us. So they were kind of like problem solvers, like, you know, we don't really have a system. We have to accept cash and checks, and then we have to retail taxes. When that hit, I was like, how are we going to do this? Now we have a web note of everything. We know exactly what type of retail we sold, when, to who, how, and it gets charged at the end of the month so that it becomes such a great system. So that to us was an unexpected benefit without even needing to look for another service to complement that.
Again, I hate to say this again, but it's been so long since I haven't had a billing. I can't remember back then. I just know that for us, it was all about saving time and building relationships, and that was what we were hoping for, and that's totally what we got with Member Solutions. If I was going to say there's a surprise benefit, is that it just all went better than expected. We were hoping to save time. We saved more than we thought. We were hoping to make it easier to interact, and we did, but it was even easier than we anticipated. So we got everything kind of magnified from what we hoped would happen. So I'd say that would be the benefit that kind of stands out in my mind.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Those are really great responses. I haven't seen any other questions come through. So
anybody? We have them all.
Some dynamic duo here. We got it.
You know. Honestly, Brett and Rob show with Jen co-hosting, moderating. See you guys next Thursday, 11 o'clock. Not Pacific time. I learned that rule. If you guys didn't know, you were late. We were late because of me, so my fault. But, guys, it's episode one. We'll get better at this.
Yeah, absolutely. And we won't even have to race the red bar next time.
It's actually, no. I found this thing called a charger. I'll bring that next time when I'm not racing from my home to get here to better internet coverage.
Awesome.
I'll tell you, I don't know where you live in Utah, but the internet here in California is not as, like, pristine as everyone makes it out to. So I have to come to the gym to get this internet. But we're way off topic, Jen. Take control here.
It's okay. So just again, Brett, Rod, thank you so much. Thank you everyone who attended today. And thank you for everyone who will be watching this replay. And thank you to everyone who commented. This was such a great discussion. I'm nose over tail for both of you. Thank you for all of the accolades and the praise. This was really fun, and I definitely would love to get together again soon. So thank you so much. And that is our webinar for today. This was fun. Thank you.
Ron, I'll drop you an email, and we'll make a time to connect if that works for
you. Yeah, but just send me your number. We can reach out, text, call, whatnot. And any school owners out there, gym members, I think Brett and I are here because we generally love to help people. So if we can help you guys out with anything, I'm not sure if I'm over speaking for you, Brett, but you seem like someone who's willing to help others, and we're more than happy to help or reach out to Jennifer at Member Solutions, and she kind of head you in the right direction.
Yeah.
Really easy to find on Facebook. So
yeah. And for all of us at Member Solutions, if there's anybody who's curious about billing or anything else in the industry, talk to us. We do free 15-minute consultations. There's actually a link right now in the chat box for anyone who's attending live here. For anyone who's watching the replay later on, hit up our website at membersolutions.com, and we'll see what we can do for you.
Awesome.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
Yeah, it was awesome.
We'll chat very soon. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. All right, take care, guys. Thanks.
Bye.
Bye-bye.